Okay, hello year three and welcome to our first lesson for RE for this term. So as we go through this lesson, which has been recorded for you, you are more than welcome to pause it, rewind it, and re-watch bits that you think you might need to see again. So please don't worry if I'm going too fast for you, just stop it and go at your own pace. So lesson one, we're going to start, as we always do in school, with our knowing more and remembering more. So I want you just to write down what you think the answer is. Question one, the Bible is the core text used by Christians that help them to live their lives. True or false? So you can just write number one, true or false. What do you think? And I'll show you the answers on the next slide. Question two. Tick the phrase that best completes this sentence. Jesus Christ was sent here on earth to teach people the truth and save them from their sins, get people to question their way of living, reunite with his family and friends, or was it to perform amazing miracles? If you think the first one, you can just write the letter A. If you think the second one, you can just write the letter B, C for the third one, or D for the fourth one. So which of those four phrases best completes this sentence? And question three, in what book of the Bible can we find the story about God's creation? Oh, it's a bit of a tricky one. Can you remember the name of the book? Okay, once you've done those, if you've got a different color pen or pencil, you might want to get that so we can mark them just like we were in school. And are you ready for the answers? Here they come. So it is true that the Bible is the core text that is used by Christians to help them live their lives. And it is the first one for question two. Jesus Christ was sent here on earth to teach people the truth and save them from their sins. And question three, well done if you got this one correct. I thought this was a tricky question. The book that the story of the creation is in the book of Genesis. So well done, you three, if you managed to get those questions correctly. I wonder who got 100%, who got 3 out of 3 today. Okay, so what are we learning to do today? So our learning objective for today says that we are going to recognize and identify different religious festivals. So thinking about different religions. And our key question is thinking about, well, what is worth celebrating? And then we have our success criteria underneath. This is how we will know that we have been successful in our learning today. So you'll be successful if you know what a religious festival is. And I'm sure some of you already do know the answer to that one. That you can give examples of what matters most to religious believers in festivals. You'll be successful if you can discuss the similarities, so what's the same, and the differences between religious festivals. And for your challenge for today, you can suggest ideas of what is worth celebrating at religious festivals. So lots for us to be getting on with today. Okay, so what is worth celebrating? So I want you to think about great parties and celebrations that you have been to or you might have seen. What was it that was being celebrated? So just think to yourself, what was the celebration for? I'm just popping some pictures up for you. These might help you get some clues. So we've got on the left, we've got some children around a cake that's got candles on it. What celebration do you think that was for? I'm going to come back and give you the answer in a minute. Then if we go next along, we have got two people that are dressed in white. What celebration might that be? They're dressing very smart. Then if we go above that one, we can see that we've got some adults or young adults that have got some hats and they're holding them up. I wonder if anyone knows what celebration that might be linked with. And then the last one, we've just got five children who are all very happy and smiley and looks like they're posing for a photo. So what was being celebrated? So let's go back. So I think if we go back to the first one on the left, that looks to me like a birthday party because we've got lots of party food and we've got a cake which has got candles on it. And often we have candles on our cakes that tell us how many years old somebody is. So that looks like a birthday party. So celebrating somebody being another year older. Then the one underneath with the two people in white, that looks to me like that is a wedding celebration, which is celebrate the fact that those who have just got married, which means that they are saying they want to spend the rest of their lives together. So that's a good celebration. Now, the one above that I think is quite tricky. This one to me is a graduation. My turn, your turn, graduation. Perfect, well done. So graduation is when you finish university. So if you've gone to university and you've got yourself a degree, you will graduate. And often people wear these caps and a lot of people will throw them into the air to celebrate they finished their university degree. Obviously they catch them again before they fall to the ground. So we're celebrating a graduation, finishing university. And this last one, you've probably got a lot more ideas than me, but this looks like it could just be a party. Maybe because of the lights in the background, it could be a Christmas party, but it could be maybe fireworks. So maybe it could be, I don't know, bonfire night. What do you think? So there's lots of ideas around that one because it's hard. That one's a harder one to tell. Okay, so. What would you like to celebrate? So we've seen some pictures there of some celebrations. If you imagine, and I know at the moment that school is closed because of coronavirus, but if you imagine that we were going to close the school for one day every year, but celebrate something, what would it be and why? So imagine that all schools were going to be closed for an extra day a year to celebrate something. So, for example, it could be to celebrate the school's birthday. That might be something that we all close the school for. Or it could be that we have a day of being closed for climate change, and we have a climate change day because we need not that we celebrate climate change, but about making action and celebrating the things we can do to help it. So, can you think of something that's happened in your life that you would think would be worth celebrating every year? Now, it says there to be prepared to share these answers with your class. Now, at the moment, we can't do that, so you can certainly share them with people in your house that you live with. So, what would you like to celebrate? I think we should celebrate Mr. Church's birthday every year and have that day off school. Perhaps. What do you think? Okay. So, oops. There are different events and values that are celebrated by people across the world. So, I'm going to play you a video now. I'll also pop the link to the video, just in case it doesn't play properly for you or you want to watch it at your own time, that shows different celebrations by people across the world. And I want you to be thinking while you're watching it, and the question is in the red box for you on the right-hand side. Have you ever been part of any of the celebrations that we're going to see in the video? And if so, what did they mean to you?
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go,
so we must sing now.
Okay, so we had a look then at some different celebrations that happen in different places around the world and that are important to different people. So have you been involved in any of those celebrations? And if so, what did they mean to you and how did they make you feel when you were part of them? So let's move on a little bit. And I know it says both partners, we're going to have to do this on our own, or maybe if you've got someone at home that can help you. Can you sort these celebrations into religious celebrations and those that are not religious? So I'm going to help you out and give you an example here. So, for example, being baptized, we can see on the left, the second one down underneath birth, is a ceremony that happens if you are a Christian, if you believe in Christianity. So that is a religious celebration. But having a graduation from school, if we look on the right hand side at the top, that doesn't matter what religion you are. Everybody will graduate from school. So all of you, when you leave Harris Garrard, you will have graduated from school. You will have left school. And it doesn't matter about religion. That happens to everybody. Okay, so that is something that is non-religious, your school graduation. But a baptism is only something that happens if you are part of the Christian faith. for example. Okay, so can you sort them out? If you want to, you might want to put a tick next to the ones you think are religious and a cross next to the ones you think are not religious. Or you could do an R for religious and an N for non-religious. Can you sort them? Okay, now this might be a good time to pause the video so you can do this at a pace that works for you, but I'm going to skip on and show you the answers. So these are the religious ones. And these are the non-religious ones, okay? So just to explain some of the ones that are non-religious that some of us might have got confused with, if we think about a wedding, typically the weddings that we see on TV or that we certainly hear about are usually a Christian wedding, but there are other religious celebrations that can be a wedding, but there are also weddings that can happen that are non-religious. So for example, when I got married, 2019, 2 years ago now, it was a non-religious ceremony. It was a civil ceremony. Okay, so there are things that can happen that might be a wedding that is not religious. So if you've had it in both, that's actually okay. It will depend on the actual wedding that is taking place. And there's your question for these. Can you describe one that you've been to before? And can you explain how you felt and why you think it might have been an important celebration? Okay, now this is your independent task for today. Please ignore the date at the top. And it says that what we would like you to do is thinking back to that celebration day, it said, could you imagine if you could have your own day when schools were closed? I want you now to plan what that celebration might look like. What would happen on that day? So you've got a word bank there to help you with some words in it. And it does say copy and complete sentences in your book, but I would like you to do this. You can just do this on some paper, that's absolutely fine. But the important thing is that you are thinking about planning a celebration of your own that is going to be a new festival for you, a new celebratory day. I wonder what you will come up with. And then once you've done that, just to recap our learning from today. So we have our religious celebrations in our blue box. We have a non-religious celebrations in our green box, although we did say that something like a wedding could be a religious celebration as well, okay? And let's think about, just to remind us, and this may certainly help you, you might want to go back to the task I'd set you earlier and think about how we have our celebrations. So which of these celebrations do we remember a story? Which of them are celebrated by everybody? Which of them raise money? Which of these celebrations do people share food in? What about exchanging gifts? And which ones remind people of beliefs and values? Now, when you're going back and you might be thinking about planning your own festival for your celebration day, you might want to think about these things. So will there be a story that's part of it that is told or acted out, for example? Will there be an opportunity for food to be shared? What about exchanging gifts? Okay, so I'm going to end our lesson for today there. As I said, I will pop the YouTube video link in the on the website for you as well. But remember, you can go back and rewatch parts of this and fast forward if you need any of it. And I hope that you have planned some amazing celebrations, and I'm sure that there will be great ones, and I can't wait to hear all about them when we are back in school.